Hi friends, welcome back to Leading Healthcare the Christian Way. I'm really excited to share with you that we were able to get a hold of the author of this book, 31 Days of Prayer, The Father's Heart Recovery for the Nation, named Linda Hanratty. And she told us to go ahead and share her book titled 31 Days of Prayer. So I have an audacious challenge for all of you, my viewers, to pray with me in the next 31 days. It requires about 6 to 10 minutes of your time. And I'm really excited about this because once we start praying together, we will see the miraculous hand of God overturn and change the course of our history. As we go through the book together and we pray together, we pray for ourselves, our family members, and our communities together. For those of you who are interested to know what's inside the book, I would like to give you an overview of what the table of contents are. Well, it says here, day 1 to 31, there are different topics. Day 1, the call to arm for battle, which we already read yesterday during our prayer every Wednesday. And then it goes on to say recovery from the coronavirus, rebuilding the church after COVID-19 assimilation, the modern day leader facing a complex world, discipleship, multiplication, healing of national divisions and factions, transform confusion and deep darkness with an explosion of light, community violence, intentional political destabilization of our nation, the elections, and day 31, pray in the glory and wrap up prayer. In the foreword, the author also told us that what can we do about what's going on? We can't continue to watch CNN and complain. We need to start doing something. The most effective thing you can do is to pray in faith. Second, you need to encourage others to seek God in prayer, asking Him to intervene in our country. And finally, for United States of America, we need to vote for the candidates who uphold godly values. Now, some of you do not live in United States of America. I encourage you to replace the nations, the name of the country from United States to the name of your countries. I know some of you who are viewing these videos that I have posted in the past are from the Philippines. You can claim the same promises for your own country. Thank you so much for joining me. So in the following pages, there are 31 prayers for 31 days. We urge you to tell others about it so that more and more people will actively pray for this homeland we love, one nation under God. Since the beginning of 2020, our nation and the world have witnessed rapid changes and trauma. The school, the business, the church shutdowns across the nation, a crashing economy, record-breaking unemployment, shortages, etc. And also, the overwhelmed healthcare workers. There are so many people that are hurting right now, and the best first way is to pray. We must not stand by being idle and just watching what's going on. We need to take action. Press in and engage in the battle by praying. God has given us the authority and sons and daughters of Jesus Christ to stand in the gap to pray His word and His will. So what have we been teaching and learning for the past several weeks is claiming God's word into our lives, because once God stated something in the Bible, it will come into fruition. But it needs our role to play, which is to pray. Day 1, call to arm for battle, Isaiah 6:8-10. I heard the voice of the Lord saying, whom shall I send? And who will go for us? Then I said, here I am, Lord, send me. Ezekiel 22:30. So I sought for a man among them who would make a wall and stand in the gap before me on behalf of the land, that I should not destroy it. But I found no one. So this is God telling us. My child, I'm searching the world to and fro for those who love me, who know the power of prayer and will eagerly take a stand. I ask you, will you stand in the gap for your city, for your state and the nation? Do not be afraid or discouraged because of this vast army, for the battle is not yours, but God's. You will not need to fight in this battle. Position yourselves, stand still, and see the salvation of the Lord, who is with you. Do not fear or be dismayed. Go out against them, for the Lord is with you. Therefore, as you are faithful to pray and seek the face of God, the Lord will march out like a champion, like a warrior. He will stir up his zeal. With a shout, he will raise the battle cry and will triumph over his enemies. Who is the King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle. Therefore, it is an utmost importance to ready yourself to war by putting on the armor of God. So arm yourselves. So arm yourselves before the Lord for the war. Put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. So let's pray. O Lord, as we meditate upon these scriptures and prayers penned upon these pages, may the words sink deeply into the soil of our hearts, bringing forth a harvest of righteousness, all for the glory and honor of your holy name. We thank you for all your promises, so we boldly enter the land without fear. For the battle belongs to you, Lord. Help us enter your courts with praise, thanksgiving, faith, and boldness, for the weapons of warfare are not carnal, but mighty in God for pulling down strongholds. What that means is that we don't use our flesh to fight. The weapons of our warfare are mighty. They are not carnal. They are mighty through the Spirit of God. Personal prayer. Lord, help me to be strong in the Lord and in His mighty power. I clothe myself in heavenly armor, putting on the full armor of God so that I may take my stand against the devil's schemes. For my struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. Therefore, I put on the full armor of God, so when the day of evil comes, I may be able to stand my ground. And after I have done everything to stand, Lord, help me stand firm with the belt of truth buckled around my waist, with the breastplate of righteousness in place, and with my feet fitted with the readiness that comes from the gospel of peace. In addition to all this, I take up the shield of faith with which I can extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one. I take up the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the powerful word of God. Having done all, help me stand. O Lord, as I stand clothed in your righteousness, armed for battle, help me be alert and always looking to you, the author and the finisher of my faith. Give me ears to hear your voice and a heart sensitive to your Holy Spirit. I ask for wisdom to know how to pray powerfully with understanding, using your word to pray because it is mighty. And it does not return void without accomplishing what you sent it for. So in other words, whatever God has written in the Bible, if you claim that, it is not void, but it accomplishes what God sent it for in the first place. Yes, Lord, I accept your invitation to join my brothers and sisters in Christ. Together, let us form a battle line of prayer that will shake this nation. Together, may we boldly stand our ground and see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. For whatever is born of God overcomes the world. And this is the victory that has overcome the world. Our faith. Who is he who overcomes the world? But he who believes that Jesus is the Son of God. I thank you, Heavenly Father, for giving us your Son, Jesus Christ, and for his sacrificial work on the cross. Thank you that he has already overcome the world. I place all my faith in Christ alone It is through Christ I too am victorious overcomer, born of the Spirit and clothed in His righteousness. Lord, I hear You call. I realize our nation is in a spiritual battle. Therefore, help me commit to daily devoting time in prayer and seeking Your face. Help me live each passing day, guided by Your Spirit and truth, bringing glory and honor to Your holy name. Together with Christ, I will be a victorious warrior. In Jesus' name, amen. If you are blessed by this video, please like, share, and subscribe to this channel so that together we can take the world for Jesus Christ. Thank you.